Ayan. So ngayon ipapakita ko sa inyo paano mag-scouting. So ayan, as you can see, nag-short position ako dito sa area na to. So nakikita ko siya ng downtrend movement. Okay, so possible bumalik nga siya, no? Possible bumagsak yung price niya ni Ethereum. So tingnan niyo, mag-scalp lang tayo. So kukurut-kurut lang tayo. Pakita natin sa inyo. So Ethereum, punta tayo Ethereum. So si Ethereum natin is dito sa mark area na to. Okay. So punta tayo 1 minute time frame ni Ethereum. So as you can see, na short position na natin si na short natin si Ethereum dito, short din natin dito, and then long tayo dito papunta sa equilibrium. And now, nung pumunta dito sa part na to si Ethereum, short position na natin siya. Kumurot na ako dito. So, ayan. So tingnan niyo. Nagkakaroon na siya ng sign of weakness around dito sa part na to. So tingnan natin. Ayan. So minsan bago-bago to, no? So kung makikita nyo, negative kayo whatsoever, pero you need to control your emotions. So kung nakikita, yeah, positive na naman, and then mamaya $1 na yan and all that. Pero dito kasi, no, nakikita ko ng sign of weakness. So pag nag $3 mark, pag nag $5 mark tayo, TTP na tayo, close position na natin siya. Okay, pero around yun dito sa part na to for sure. Ayan, so makikita nyo, it's a bearish candlestick, bearish kicker, so let's confirm it. Punta tayo ng candlestick pattern. So bearish harami na to. So nagkaroon tayo ng bearish harami around this part na to. So it's a short position nga. Okay, during a downtrend, tingnan natin, during uptrend to, nagkaroon tayo ng green candlestick. So ngayon bearish harami na to. So tingnan natin kung ano mangyayari dito sa candlestick na to. Ayan. So oops, nag-doji, walang meaning yan. So tingnan lang natin, hintayin natin. Meron na lang tayong 30 seconds to close yung candlestick na to. Ayan o, makikita nyo dito, meron na lang tayong 25 seconds to close. And boom, there you go, half a dollar take profit. Titingnan natin kung kung ano yung matitake profit natin dito sa part na to. So almost a half dollar na to. So tingnan natin, ayan, boom, $1. Okay, $1 na to. So tingnan natin, oops, tumataas na naman. Ayan, so kailangan mabilis yung kamay nyo pagka ganyan. So magkaklose to in 2, 1, 0. Oops, it's a bearish harami, it's confirmed na bearish harami na tong trend na to, yung candlestick na to. So possible mag downtrend nga ito. Okay, possible mag-downtrend ito papunta dito sa area na to. So kung i-close position natin to around dito sa part na to, pwede na. Okay, pwede na. Dito sa part ng bearish harami na to. So and as you can see, almost a $2 mark. Ayan. It's a $2 and boom, markup $2. Ayan, $2 na tayo. So and almost $3. Ayan. So makikita nyo, it's almost $3 and going $4. Tingnan natin. Ayan na. So it's a bearish candlestick during an uptrend position, gawa ng bullish engulfing, no? So bearish kicker na rin 'yan kasi wala siyang paa, no? And boom, almost $4 na 'yan. So tingnan natin. Ayan, so malapit na 'to. So and ayan na, kinikik na siya pababa. Pinupush na siya pababa, okay? Pinupush na siya pababa. So i-close position na natin 'to once we go $4. And boom, close na naman ang ating candlestick. Nag-open na naman tayo ng panibago. It's a bullish candlestick as of now. It's a bullish candlestick pero walang meaning to. So kaya hintayin natin siya bumaba around dito sa part na to and we should close position. Okay? Dito tayo magka-close position sa part na to. And now kung titingnan naman natin siya sa higher time frame, let's move to let's try to 15 minutes time frame. Ayan, let's try to 15 minutes time frame and as you can see guys, it's a bearish candlestick. So magko-close na yan in 6 minutes. So meron pa tayong 6 candlestick na hihintayin to confirm the downside position. And as you can see guys, nasa bingit na tayo ng kamatayan. Dito tayo sa 20 moving average and 50 moving average dito sa area na to. So pinupush lang talaga ng ng market yung price pababa. So makikita natin, ayan na, it's a bearish. Okay, pababa lang yan, pababa. So meron na lang tayong 10 seconds. 10 9, 8, 7, 6, 5, 4, 3, 2, and boom, tumataas siya. So, kung titingnan natin siya sa ating portfolio, nagiging negative na tayo niyan. Okay, tumataas yung price, so nababawasan yung ating profit. So, tingnan natin, and boom, bearish ulit. So, wala siyang magagawa, guys. Talagang downtrend movement lang to, kasi kung titingnan nyo sa 15 minutes time frame niya, it's a bearish candlestick. Okay, so punta tayo sa 15 minutes. Pakita natin. Okay, itong candlestick na to, sa 15 minutes time frame, candlestick identified, it's a bearish harami. Okay, as of now, bearish harami na bubuo. Meron na lang tayong 5 minutes to confirm na downtrend na yung mangyayari. Kasi during the uptrend position yun eh. Ano yan? Ha? Okay. So, ayan. So makikita nyo, nagpupula na tayo, no? Pula-pula na yung portfolio natin. Negative na tayo. So kanina, almost $4 na tayo, and now, negative tayo. So ibig sabihin, nababawasan yung ating pera. So may tinatawag naman tayo leveraging. Ayan, naka 20x lang ako, mababa lang yan. Okay, mababa lang yan. So safe position na tayo sa scalping. So as you can see, it's a bullish kicker candlestick. Itong nabuo na to, it's a bullish kicker candlestick. So tumataas yung trend natin, no? Pero nope, hindi siya tapapayagan yan. Gawa nga talaga, bearish harami yung nabuo natin during an uptrend position. And so 15 minutes time frame natin, paulit-ulit lang yan. Sa 15 minutes time frame natin, is a bearish candlestick. Ayan o, bearish kickers. Bearish harami siya sa 15 minutes time frame. So meron na tayong 4 minutes to confirm the trend. So meron na tayong 4 minutes. Tingnan natin. So ayan, meron tayong doji. Wala ulit meaning yan, no? So titingnan natin. It's a bearish. Okay, bearish ulit. So tingnan natin. Almost a dollar na naman. So babagsak na naman to. And tataas, baba, taas, baba. Okay, so ganyan yan. You need to confirm, talaga, kailangan yung ayusin yung emotions nyo once you trade. Kasi talaga mahirap siya. So ito, live trade itong ginagawa natin para lang ma-imagine nyo kung gano'ng ka-stressful yung 1 minute time frame sa scalping. Okay, so ayan. Hindi ko po pinagbabasihan itong candlestick identified for take profit position and positioning. Hindi. Okay, binabasa ko lang yung movement ng candlestick kasi hindi naman natin kaya i-memorize lahat-lahat yan. Okay, some of you may, and some of you not. Okay, hindi nyo maintindihan yan. So now, we're back at $2 profit. So tingnan natin, and boom, bearish kicker during an uptrend position. Ito yung pinakamagandang part. Bullish kicker, bullish candlestick during, nagkaroon tayo ng bearish candlestick during an uptrend position. So that confirms us a bearish trend. Okay, possible, bumagsak na talaga to. So meron na lang tayong 30 seconds. So meron na 30 seconds. So now, let's go back to 15 minutes time frame. Ito. So tandaan nyo, Ethereum yung pinaglaruan ko. So, ayan na. Meron na lang tayong 3 minutes to confirm the downtrend. And tignan nyo, hindi pa rin nagbabago. It's a bearish harami pa rin. Okay? So, tingnan natin. Ayan. So, bantayan lang natin siya. So, you need to control your emotions. Tignan nyo ako, hindi na ako na-attack. Hindi ako na-attack. I-close position yung market. So, as you can see, ayan. Magti-$3 na ulit tayo. So, magko-close na. Entry, 2, 1. Close na. Opening na naman tayo ng candlestick. And now, it confirms as a bearish bearish confirmation nga. Ulit. Again. Bearish candlestick. So, boom. $4 mark profit. So, let's close that position around dito sa part na to. Pag nag-387 na siya, pwede na natin siya i-close with $5 profit siguro, I think. So, at dito sa part na to, possible $5 yung profit natin. So, tingnan natin. Ayan, bearish candlestick, it will close in 2 minutes. 2 minutes na lang, guys. So, meron na lang tayong 2 candlestick na hinihintay. Kasi nga, 1 minute time frame yung scalping natin. So, makikita nyo dyan. Ayan. So, pwede natin exit to para hindi kayo malito. Ayan, sa bearish kicker. Okay, bearish kicker yan. Ang bearish kicker po is wala siyang paa. Okay, walang paa yung candlestick na yon. Or wala siyang buntot. Okay, ika nga. So, meron na tayo 15 minutes. 15 seconds to close the candle. In 10, 9, 8, 7, 6, 5, 4, 3, 2, 1. Okay, it opens a bullish candlestick pero it will drive down. So, as you can see, tumataas na naman yung market. Meron tayo $1 ulit na profit, back to $1. And meron na lang tayong 2 minutes. 2 minutes na lang, guys. Meron na lang tayong 2 candlestick na hinihintay para malaman na natin na downtrend na to sa 15 minutes time frame. In that case, pwede na tayo makapag-take profit around dito sa area na to. Kasi it's a confirmed na bearish na yung trend. Okay? Confirmed na siya sa 15 minutes. Okay, 15 minutes. Tandaan nyo, scalping is 1 minute. 15 minutes is a swing trade. Okay? So, makikita nyo to. Ayan. So, tingnan natin. Hintayin natin. So, ayan na. Magne-negative na tayo, di ba? So, you need to control your emotions talaga once you trade. So, back to $1. O, di ba? Nakakainis. Nakakainis siya. So, ganun. So, you need to control your emotions. So, candlestick identified. Sa bearish harami na naman yung nabuo. Meron na naman tayong back in $2 na naman tayo in profit. So, as you can see dyan, sa part niya. And, boom. 7, 6, 5, 4, 3, 2, 1. It's close position. Boom, close, and it will drive down. Ayan na, bumagsak na yung price. Okay, $5 profit. Close tayo ng $5, guys, ha? Dito, ida-drive natin yung price pababa. So, meron na lang tayo one minute, guys. Ayan na. It will drive us to 1 minute na lang. Okay, magkoclose na yung 15 minutes natin. Pwede na natin siya i-close. Whether we like it or not, close na natin siya kasi confirm na yun for downtrend. And $5 na tayo. In 3, close na natin siya pag nag $5 na to. Okay, pwede na siya i-close pag nag-$5 na to. And, tingnan natin. 3, okay, meron pa tayong 20 seconds pa pala, sorry. So, ayan, tingnan natin. Oops, magiging dragonfly pa nga to. Hintayin natin. So $4 mark, oops, bullish, marami na naman yung nabuo within last minute, okay, last call, last minute. So tingnan natin, balik tayo dito sa 15 minutes time frame natin kay Ethereum. So ayan, makikita nyo. So magko-close na siya in 5, ayan na, 5, 4, 3, 2, 1. Ayan, it opens below. Ayan na, guys. Confirm na, it's a bearish harami. So punta tayo, balik tayo sa 15 minutes time frame. Yeah, candlestick identified. And it confirms na bearish harami na po ito. So possible, babagsak na po yan. Kasi during uptrend position, nangyari yung bearish harami. Okay? Ganun lang siya, pasimple. So now, pwede na natin siya i-close position. Balik na tayo sa 1 minute time frame natin. $4 na tayo and almost $5. Ayan na. So almost $5 na tayo, guys. And boom! Ayan na. Pwede natin siya i-TP. Entry. Ayan na. 4.TP. Ayan na. Close position na tayo. Now we earn $5 in profit. So ganun lang siya kasimple. Ganyan ang scalping. Ganyan ka-stressful ang scalping. So, okay. Nakita nyo. Nag-short tayo dito sa area na to. Continue tayo nakakita ng bearish confirmation na candlestick during an uptrend position, kasi uptrend yung nangyari, magkakaroon tayo ng bearish and boom, it will drive down the price back to dito sa area na to, which is a confluence area. So ganun lang kasimple yung scalping, guys. Close position na tayo, now we're in profit of $5. Meron na tayo ngayon available na meron tayo available na $131. Okay, so profitable tayo ng $5 doon, which is okay na yun. Okay, pag nanalo kayo, okay na yun. Huwag na kayo mag revenge trade. Once na matalo kayo, tigil muna kayo. Okay, so that's it, guys. Bye bye, peace out.